Hi, in this video, we'll learn how to add unlike fractions. So first of all, unlike fractions are fractions that have different denominators. Now, for example, the first fraction is 3/5 and the second fraction is 2/6. The first fraction has a denominator of 5, the second fraction has a denominator of 6. So since the denominators are different, they're called unlike fractions. Now, when you have unlike fractions, you can't add or subtract them. So, since I have to add these fractions, how do I do that? So, first of all, we need to change our unlike fractions into like fractions. That means we'll have to find a common denominator, or you can say that I want to make the denominators equal. And I'll show you a simple way how to do that. So, what I'm going to do is I will multiply each fraction with the denominator of other fraction. So, let's talk about this fraction first, 2/6. So I have to multiply both the fractions here. I will multiply both the fractions. Now I have to think, what do I multiply here to make the denominators equal? I'm trying to make the denominators equal. So I'll multiply each fraction with the denominator of other fractions. Now here, I have this fraction. I will multiply this fraction by the denominator of other fraction. What is the denominator of other fraction? It's 5. That means I will multiply this by 5. Now remember, since I'm multiplying the denominator by 5, I will have to multiply the numerator by 5 so that I'm not changing the value of the fraction, because 5 over 5 is equal to 1. So I haven't changed the value of the fraction, but I have generated an equivalent fraction to it. When you multiply the numerators and denominators, the new generated fraction will be equivalent to this fraction. Okay, so now here, I'm talking about this fraction, 3/5. What do I multiply here to make the denominator equal? So I will multiply this fraction with the denominator of other fractions. So what is the denominator of other fraction? It's 6. So I'll multiply this fraction by 6 over 6. Since I can't just multiply the denominators, I will have to multiply the numerators and the denominator with 6. Just to, because 6 over 6 is 1, and I'm not changing the value of the fraction. So 6 times 3, now we'll just multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. 6 times 3 is going to be 18. And then 6 times 5 will be 30. Plus 2 times 5 is going to be 10. 6 times 5 is going to be 30 again. Now you can see that I have the same denominators, right? I have the same denominators. We can just add the numerators. Now remember, when adding fractions or subtracting fractions, you only add or subtract the numerators. You never change your denominators. The denominator will still remain same. So our denominator will be 30. We will not change our denominator. And numerators, we'll just add it, because since we have the plus sign in between, 18 plus 10 is going to be 28. So my answer will be 28 by 30. But you can see that I can still reduce this fraction. I want to reduce this fraction to simplest form. So to reduce this fraction to simplest form, I will have to think about the greatest common factor. Greatest common factor, let's write down the factors of 28. Factors of 28 are 2, 7, 14, and 28. And let's write down the factors of 30. So factors of 30 are 2, 3, 5, then 10, then 15, and then 30. Well, we don't have to go that far, because we just got the greatest common factor here. My greatest common factor is 2. So greatest common factor is 2. I can divide this fraction by 2, dividing the numerator and the denominator by 2, because remember, I don't want to change the value of my fraction, so I will have to divide numerator and denominator both by 2. Now, 28 divided by 2 is going to be 14, and then 30 divided by 2 is going to be 15. So my final answer is 14 over 15. So when you have to add the fractions 3/5 and 2/6, you will get 14 over 15. So my final answer will be here. 3/5 plus 2/6 is equal to 14 over 15. That's how you add the fractions in a very simple way. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next video.